In this illustration, we are going to analyze another pulley system, few we already discussed. Here we are given that in the figure shown, we are required to find acceleration of this 5 kg mass if system is set free to move. And in solution, the very first thing we need is to deduce the constraint relation of motion in the three blocks. Now if you have a look on this figure, here I'll first distribute the tension. This is the longest string available. Say if we consider tension in this string as T, then throughout the string tension will remain T as we are assuming ideal pulley and strings. So here tension will be 2T as we have discussed for massless pulleys, net force is equal to 0. Here also if the tension is T, in this string tension will be 2T. Now for the three blocks, if we consider this 10 kg block, we assume going up with an acceleration A1, this 10 kg is going down with acceleration A2, and say this 5 kg is going up with acceleration A3. So first we write down the equation of virtual work method using which we deduce the constraint relation. Here we can write for constraint relation of accelerations, here we use the total work done by all the strings in the system should be equal to 0, which is resulting in this situation. For this 10 kg, 2T is acting in upward direction and its displacement will be proportional to A1. So this 2T A1. For this 10 kg, T is upward and A2 is in downward direction, so it is minus T A2. For this 5 kg, we have assumed it is going up, so it will be plus 2T A3, and that should be 0. And it is resulting us the relation and acceleration as T gets cancelled out, and is giving us A2 is equals to twice of A1 plus twice of A3. Now, this is the constraint relation of acceleration we are having. Now we can directly write the equations of motion for blocks. One by one we can write for these. We talk about this 10 kg block as 2t is in upward direction, its weight is downward. We can write 2t minus 10g, that will be 100, is equal to its ma, that is 10a1, that is say our equation 1. For the second 10 kg block, as we have considered it to be going down, its weight minus tension, we can take up this 100 minus T is equals to 10A2, that is our second equation. And the third equation for this 5 kg, as we have considered it is going up, we can write upward forces 2T minus 5G is 50. Here I have taken g to be equals to 10 meter per second square and is going up at A3, this phi A3, that's equation 3. Now to solve these equations, first what we can do, we can eliminate t from these two equations. So here 1 minus 3 will result, this 2t gets cancelled out, and here 1 minus 3 will be resulting as minus 50 is equals to this 10A1 minus 5A3, which further simplifying is giving us A3 minus 2A1 is equals to 10. And from 1 and 2, if we wish to eliminate T, we can do like this, 1 plus twice of equation 2. And this resulting us on the left hand side, 1 plus twice of 2 will be 100. T gets cancelled out, and on right hand side this will be 10A1 plus twice of 10A2, that is 20 times A2. A2 I can substitute from this equation, which is 2A1 plus 2A3, and this is resulting as here this 10 gets cancelled out, and I am having 2 into 2, 4A1 plus A1, this 5A1 plus 2 multiplied by 2, this 4A3 is equals to 10. So as we have got these two equations and we are required to find the value of A3, the acceleration of 5 kg mass, so we need to eliminate A1. So we can multiply first equation with 5, second with 2, and we add up these two equations. So here if we add these two, this minus 10a1 and 10a1 gets cancelled out. Here it is 5a3 plus 8a3. This will be 13a3 is equals to 50 plus 20, 70, which is resulting as the value of a3, that is 70 by 13 meter per second square. That's the result of this problem.